There's no more fog now. Pardon my hand in the viewfinder. The dog. Give me a sec. Right. No, there is no sponsor for Monster. Wish there was, but there's not. Sorry, little flower, but I don't know what the heck is going on here. And at least I cut it on camera. The song says, all that glitters isn't always gold. Damn, this fucking water is not helping me at all. Get out of here. There we go. So, we got that, and now we have that. Now, the fancy yellow. There we go. Is it much different? Not very much. It's more of a golden color. So let's do something here. Let's take another cup. It's blue in it. Let's take a little bit of rose red, which seems to be a reoccurring theme. Just a dash. Give it a little bit of something else. Yeah. I think more red. Yeah. Too much. Yeah, that red just absolutely took over. So, put some more yellow in it. Do as well is for a little extra flair. Oops, one more. Extra flair. Which one is this? No, I have some yellow glow in the dark. Fortunately, they come in small vials, but you need a crap ton to get it to work. This has a better looking orange. Not entirely a yellow, but definitely more than just a boring yellow on yellow. Because I got some copper in there. Ooh, that actually makes for a really nice copper color. Best part is, it's all glow in the dark too. So, this client is going to be super stoked, I bet. She said yellow is her friend's favorite color. So, I know it's orange, but at the same time, isn't orange just part of, or isn't yellow just part of orange? Really like this color. I might use it on one of my own personal designs here in a little bit. Uh-oh, what's this? Let's scrape some of that off. There we go. Don't know if you can see that, but water. That up here too. I'm surprised with the roses. You know, talking to a blank canvas or a blank camera is kind of fun. I know it's not live, but at the same time, it is kind of nice. Whoa, we did get really close to that copper color. We are so good. Look at that. Of course, once the resin hits this, it's going to change it slightly. Because I'm going to use a silver as a base for this one to make sure it brings out the yellows and the golds. Definitely that copper bit. Now I'm glad it didn't mess with the teeth too much, because that would have really messed with the whole design. Now that it has that glow powder in it, this is gonna glow in the night. Just a faint glow. So maybe the person might think they're going crazy because they see it glowing. These two beady red eyes, are not red, but silverish eyes looking at them. I don't like that there. Let's take that off. Every nook and cranny. Hands are covered in yellow because I don't wear gloves. Yeah, actually, I think I might use this same color on my other project that's behind it. On that little thing back there. I might use that on that. But anyways, so let's. No, 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 no. this. And my favorite part, just boop. That is what it's gonna look like on the inside. And once it's complete, I might have to do some trim work. That's a drink. That's a skull. I do have the skull, and we're about to pour into it. But we're gonna have to pour this one slowly because there's an area. Actually, there's a couple areas that don't like to get the resin in, and it makes for a huge pain in my ass because the leaves of it go up, so I actually have to break out that air pocket when making this. So my hand's in the way. So let's, there we go, nice. There's the air pocket that I was looking for. Air bubble. Kind of looks like caramel a little bit. Is it caramel or caramel? Still think it's caramel. It up. Oh, I'm using a small little blowtorch that you can buy at any smoke shop. So here we go.